But the boys are brilliant.
Billy, how'd you feel?
Yeah, good. I'm going to come out with two, let's go.
Yeah, they won it last year, so they're very confident. But the Charlton lads have worked hard for the last few months, to be fair, coming in the morning early and working hard. So they done well, but my lads will be back. We'll be working hard, going back to the drawing board.
That's the first time I've ever put a team out that I've been scared that I'm going to lose. Two world champions like that, it was a great race, and I think another couple of lengths, then I think they would have probably caught Billy some swimmers.
I think the players have been training hard in the morning, so tumble turns they weren't doing last year. They probably put the hours in, and fair play to them, great turnout. And the best thing for me is that they've taken the lads seriously. They know how good of swimmers they are. They've come here today to win it, and in great spirit the event's been held again. You know. So, you know, for me it just shows how the project's grown, the support it gets from the club and our sponsors and the fans, and we're looking forward to this year's Upbeats Walk on the 13th of April and hope the fans come out and support this great project again. The 13th of April, big event again, the Upbeats will be playing on the pitch prior to the first team fixture, and it's a 9-mile walk again from the valley, new route this year. Sorry for the training round, yeah, thanks for correcting me there. But we're hoping to raise, you know, last year was a great event, fundraising was down slightly. This year we want to have a bit of a push to try and get that level of fundraising back up, which really secures the future of the project for the next couple of years, because it's an amazing project, provides so much, and you know, we hope to be able to do a really good Upbeats day this year.